What's up guys, it's Lindsay and I am back for another video. It has been indeed a while. I feel like I did not get to do a proper intro on my last video since coming back from vacation. I apologize for that because I just hadn't had time to edit this current video yet, so I filmed that one in the interim. Anyway, hello, I am back. It has been about a month since I went to Alaska. It was absolutely amazing. The weather was great. The seas were awesome. It was definitely the vacation that I needed, to say the least. I actually went to another thrift store when I was in Alaska, and it was the Salvation Army in Ketchikan. I actually ended up finding something, funny enough, and it has also already sold. This is going to be a thrift with me, and I'm not gonna do a haul because I don't have the item anymore, unfortunately, but I will post it somewhere on the screen when you get to it. I don't know if I'm going to do a voiceover on this video or not, because I took like 20 minutes of footage and I don't know how much is gonna get cut or saved. So you might just have another video of me walking through the store. Let's jump into the thrift with me. Enjoy the Salvation Army in Ketchikan. Yeah, thank you guys for watching and I will obviously see you in the next video. Peace. All right, so here it is, the little Salvation Army thrift store. It was right across from the local marina. They opened at about 10 that day, and we had already done all the sightseeing that we needed to do, so we literally were just like standing over to the side with a couple that we met from Pennsylvania, and we're just waiting for the thrift store to open. So it was pretty much like a line outside of the thrift store waiting to go in, and they were wheeling out these shopping carts as we were walking up, you know, basically waiting. And you'll see in a second that these were 25-cent carts, and that's just incredible because I don't know of any store besides like a church type store or whatever locally nowadays that even has 25-cent items. And obviously I had to be very, very picky and choosy with what it is that I was taking back with me, just because I didn't have tons of room in my suitcase, obviously, since we were going back on a ship. So I was obviously looking at all this stuff thinking, well, could I pick that up? Yeah, but you know, is it really worth it? No, not that much. But so the couple is on the other side of this cart right here, with them being from Pennsylvania, and they obviously knew that we were from Washington. That is why she passed the Seahawk shirt to me, and it was new with tags. And you know, if we would have been home, I probably would have grabbed that just because it was new with tags, but I ended up leaving it. We were the first people to be going through these carts, so they had not been picked over at all, obviously, since we walked up literally as they were putting the carts out. and so everything that's in here is, you know, what they basically had in the cart. And you will see here in a second that there is a shirt that maybe I should have grabbed because I could have run it in like a whatnot or something, but I did end up leaving it. And for 25 cents, again, I probably should have picked it up, but that's hindsight. Again, I was trying to be picky, and here it is right here. It was a Mobile, Alabama Harley Davidson shirt, and it was not vintage by any means, but you know, Harley stuff, people always kind of ask about it. So it was one of those that, you know, I probably should have grabbed, but I didn't. And the graphic was actually not bad. It was kind of cool on the back. So, but that's here nor there. So
They also had these shoe bins out. I think they were maybe $2 a pair. Not very expensive, so a pretty good deal. I walked in and I immediately wanted to go to the t-shirts. That was definitely like my first place that I was eyeing. Obviously, you can see there was a lot of people in that little area right there. And I was not able to go to the t-shirts first. I ended up going to the sweatshirts. But everything was marked pretty decently. I think the sweatshirts were like $6 or $7, I want to say. I can't remember. It wasn't very high. I will say that organizationally, the only downside to this store is that everything was like front and back on the rack. So you had a lot of stuff that wasn't facing the same way, which was making it a little hard, especially for video purposes of being able to see what the items were. I definitely was contemplating on that Oregon Duck shirt just because Oregon stuff always sells for me, but I obviously ended up leaving it. But yeah, you can see here that pants were $7 or $9. I can't tell what that says, but $7 or $9. And so pricing was definitely better than like a local Goodwill. I thought for sure that was going to be a Lululemon skirt, but it was not. This was like a vintage, I think, silk John Paul Richard skirt, and I kind of contemplated it, but I was like, style wise, I don't really know. I don't really think it's worth anything. Now this is just going obviously through women's blouses, and I was very confused because a lot of their tags, as you can see, there's like a lot of those brown tags that are hanging off. I didn't know if those were necessarily like the item tags or if those were the store tags. And so every time I saw it, I was getting confused because I thought it was like a brand new item, but I don't think it was. I think that was just the tag that the store was probably using. In this case, I was also obviously looking for vintage because that's kind of primarily what it is that I'm trying to find when I am thrifting or when I'm out. And so I definitely can do a quick scan and kind of tell what's vintage and what's not vintage, but I was not having any luck on this particular rack, other than that red velvet top. And then I saw this and I was like, oh my gosh, how beautiful. This reminds me so much of tops that I have sold, in the past, but and the color was like stunning, but I just would not have had room because it was pretty thick. And I think for the price, it wasn't necessarily worth it. But look how pretty that is on camera. It is gorgeous. Again, this made me stop because for some reason I thought this was that was a really good brand. And I was contemplating like, dang, should I have picked that up, especially because it was only $5. Again, like all the women's blouses were pretty much $5, so pricing was really, really decent in this store. But yeah, you'll see that there's just pretty much very your very basic like Walmart and Kmart, and here's a vintage Donna Karan DKNY. You know, it's just very basic. It wasn't a lot of branded stuff, which was not helpful because even if it would have been like a good Zara item or something like that, then I would have grabbed it. So you're going to see here in a second the item that I found, and I'm going to cut the audio so you can hear how excited I was.
Oh, oh. Oh man. $5. No way.
So you can tell that I was pretty happy about finding that Lululemon, and that is obviously a Swiftly Tech long sleeve that was marked at $5. I obviously came home and listed it within, I think, a couple weeks of getting home, and it sold next day for full asking, and that was just such a quick flip. I had literally like nothing into it, especially for a thrift store price. So I was very, very happy about that. Now this is just going back through the t-shirts. I don't know if I had already gone through these t-shirts at one point or if I was just going back through for the video, but this was definitely a miss on the t-shirts for sure. There was not anything. I mean, that Harley shirt that was out there in the 25-cent bin was probably the best graphic tee. It was not that great. This is now the shorts. These are some vintage energy shorts. I almost contemplated getting those, but I think they had stains or something on them. For the price, I figured that it probably wasn't worth it to get those, but I don't think I've ever seen that vintage energy tag. Here's some Sorel like boot shoes for $7, but they were pretty beat up. Again, I couldn't take home anything thick. I don't know if I've ever seen Sorel in the thrift store. So that was pretty cool to find. And then this was kind of all their like outerwear and thicker kind of items that were on the racks over here. Obviously these really cool like royal blue overalls, and then these were all evening gowns. This was a really cute vintage denim dress. And then these were obviously more dresses, and this right here you'll see because I pull it off. This is a Garnet Hill lace dress, and they had it marked at $10. And Garnet Hill, I've never actually picked it up in a dress. I think I've only picked it up in tops, and it always takes a really long time for me to sell. So I really didn't know how a dress would do. And again, room-wise, I don't really think I had room to take a dress. That was a really cool Jeffrey and Dara, or Dana, however you say it, vintage dress, which I have sold that brand before, and it has sold pretty quick. And that one was dead stock, which was unfortunate that I could not take that with me. Now we're just heading to the back of the store. This was obviously all the home goods, sheets and pillows and all of that kind of stuff. I don't know if you can see prices, but they were pretty reasonable. Again, not a huge, huge selection, but for Ketchikan, what do you expect? There probably isn't going to be that big of a selection anyway. Tons of board games, obviously, and tons of books and stuffed animals. But yeah, otherwise, this was a fun little hole in the wall in Ketchikan. Again, 10 a.m. opening for the day that we were there, which I believe was a Thursday. So I'm not sure if it's like that during the whole week, but I will definitely be stopping back again soon.